I'd like to take the opportunity today to demo our new hard case toolkit for terminating LMR1-195-200-240. It's our TK-185/200/240EZHC kit. Stock code 660-1206. As you can see, the kit contains a cutting tool, contains a crimp tool, and contains two prep tools. Now what we're going to do here, we're just going to quickly demo the termination using these tools of LMR240. We have a piece of LMR240 here. We're going to use an EZ connector. We're going to take our CCT03 cutting tool out of the kit. It's spring loaded. Just pop it onto the cable like so. Put your finger through that finger hole there. Revolve it around the table just a few times, and that piece will snap right off. And the beauty about this is that because you're not using a pair of, you know, diagonal cutting pliers or coax cutting pliers type of thing, you're leaving the center connector nice and straight with burr free. That's very important for these EZ connectors. You're also leaving the core uncrushed, and it's a very square, clean cut. So it's a great way to get started with the whole process. First thing we're going to do here is we're going to put one of our WSB 240 boots on there, put a little bit of rubber lubricant, rubber slide, get that boot started. That WSB 240 boot slides down on the cable. We'll take our crimp ferrule, slide over the cable. At that point, we're going to take our CST 240A tool out of the kit. We're going to open up side one, make sure there's nothing stuck in there. Pop that onto the cable like so. Push down that thumb switch and rotate the tool around the cable. Once that bottoms out, make one extra revolution at least, leave it depressed and pull it. And what you're doing is you're taking that whole pellet off, adhesive and all. And as you can see, I don't know how close you guys can see, but that center connector is perfectly straight and burr free. And that's really a key. And that's, you know, thanks to this cutting tool and this method of prepping, that's what you get. Now you take this tool and you flip it around to side two. You make sure it's set to straight. And it's gonna be just like an old fashioned pencil sharpener. You just take this tool and you spin it around the cable, and you'll peel that jacket back and you'll feel it when it's all peeled, just like that. The tool's spinning freely and you can actually see that piece of polyethylene just pop right off of there. So you end up with basically a perfect prep at that point. We take our connector. This happens to be an EZ-240-NMH-X connector. It's all the latest. It's a tri-metal plate. It's got ribs in the back. It's optimized for VSWR. It happens to be a no braid trim connector. No need to trim the braid wires. And it's designed to be compatible with the tool, of course, but also with this WSB 240 boot. So you take those braid wires, just fold them back a little bit. You don't need to comb them or anything. Just fold them back a little bit. Get this connector started onto the cable like so. And it's by design, it's a snug fit. It's already snug. You push it, turn it, and you can feel those fingers. It's a beryllium copper spring finger. There's four fingers that ride up onto the center connector. There's no soldering of any kind. It's very good contact, very low current density. Now the ferrule, we said this was a no braid trim. You bring that ferrule up and you'll see the braid wires are right where you want them to be. And at that point, it's a 255 hex crimp. So we have our crimp tool here, and the different crimp dies here are labeled. It's the largest, and you crimp it just once right behind the connector, like so. You don't want to crimp it a second time. If you do, you're going to pinch a jacket, crush the core, and you're going to diminish the electrical performance. By design, we wanted the jacket and the crimp ferrule to overlap, so crimp it just once. This stuff dries pretty quick, this lubricant, so you put an extra little drop there. In this boot, you can slide it forward, and you might even hear it snap in the back there. Once this snaps in the back, this is an IP67 seal. We've tested this 1 meter for 30 minutes. It's a nice seal. And not only does it seal, but it provides nice strain relief, and that's always important. Preventing moisture ingress is critical, and protecting that electrical transition between the connector and the cable is always very critical. So this kit, this crimp tool is common between the 240, the 195, and 200, as is a cutting tool, of course. So with this extra prep tool in the kit, this allows you to do the same exact thing with the LMR 200 and 185. So you end up with a very versatile kit here. You can do all three cables. You got the cutting tool and the crimp tool. Thanks a lot.